Democratic principle lies in this very fact. Democracy, people's power. A solution is made, depending on what it is considered a law and what is not. 50 plus 1, a law is adopted. 50 plus 1, a law is rejected. Do you understand? This is called a democratic principle. I would emphasize once again the fact of granting greater rights depends on the majority, or which majority would like to accept it. A very simple principle. In all parliaments, it is being solved in this way. Just in this way, decisions are taken. So it is not really important if it is 50% or two-thirds of votes. Just this is democracy. I'm speaking just about an idea. So from this point of view, let's look at equality of all religions. That is what we hear about now and then. Will it be fair that if a small religious group, which in fact a religious one, and has its own belief, its own teaching, possesses the same rights as a religion, communion with 3/4 of the population? Here, 3/4 of the population, and there, 3/4 of a man. Well, of course not. Quite obvious. If the majority of the population supports just that very organization, well, let's call it a church, so naturally it should have much bigger rights than that, for which only 1% of the population voted. Two candidates. One became president and got these great rights. The other one failed and has the rights that every person has, not more. Here it appears to be the same thing. Here there must exist a certain coefficient, a lawful coefficient. But even without a lawful coefficient, it is obvious that that very church that has a support from the overwhelming majority of the population, or just a majority of the population, should have more rights than the other. Isn't it fair? Well, no doubt, true. This is how it occurs in the West. Some churches in Europe possess primary rights. The other, that are many, do not possess them. As soon as we speak about Russia, all Western media go mad with rage. Why don't your religious minorities have the same rights as Russian church? Why isn't it a state-owned? And they pour down nonsense, whatever they want. Look, where are you from? Austria? Look how things are in your country. From Germany? Look how the whole thing is your country. France? Look, what are you speaking about? Well, you should remember that. So a democratic principle is based on an elementary principle of simple majority. I would rather cite another example. Just imagine some rich religious sect comes to a poor country where the overwhelming majority profess a single belief. Well, say, let's take Ethiopia. Well, according to a law that is in force in this country, the sect has equal rights in the press,
печати, в телевидении, ну, вообще в средствах массовой информации, так.
Television, in the mass media, as it has bought all of them, as the sect is very rich. And it starts propaganda against the religion of this population. On the one hand, yes, freedom of press, freedom of speech, why not? On the other hand, such a devil-like mockery and the principle of democracy. The majority of the population is against it. But a flood of propaganda is being poured from the screen. I believe if a referendum is to be held right now, probably the majority of the population would vote against this unbridledness, which we watch in commercials and in all other things, against that lack of morality, that dominance that takes place now. So, some would express an opinion that they are for it, but the majority will vote against. I'm sure this is not done because invisible rulers pushing forward presidents, deputies, and etc. to their post would lose their power. Shadow figures. Where is democracy then? I do not understand. It is worth mentioning in this connection to recall that St. John of Kronstadt condemned with an indignation the granting of freedoms to all religions, freedoms of equality, which was done by the last Tsar in 1905. But nobody wants to know that it is incorrect to condemn him. So I'd like to cite some words written by Ilarion Troitsky. When the Tsar abdicated in February 1917 and church got its freedoms, local council opened at last, the highest resolution.
Он писал: «Высочайшая резолюция 31 марта 1905 года».
Of March 31st, 1905, on the report of the Holy Synod on Convention of Council, had the resolution of a Tsar. I admit it impossible to commit such a great deed in the time we are surviving now. I believe a council of all Russia Church is to be convened when more favorable times comes. Илларион Троицкий writes then, years passed after years, the status of Orthodox Church was becoming unbearable. Church life was getting into disarray. The formerly persecuted religious communions got freedom. Councils of religious dissenters had their sittings embedded in ancient Orthodox Moscow. Baptists convened their congress. However, a favorable year has not come yet for an Orthodox Church. The attitude of the Tsar dynasty to the Orthodox Church is a historic example of ingratitude. The Petersburg period of the Russian history is coming to an end when an awful disgrace and heavy nationwide calamity. General Kireyev, a well-known general and a well-known theologist, monarchist, who firmly supported the idea that there should be a Tsar power in the country, not a kind of democracy, made such commentaries of freedom, giving reforms by Nicholas II. Tsar does not understand those deep changes which his laws on equality and belief introduced into our life. He mixed up freedom with equality. No one is against freedom, but equality in propaganda is quite a different thing. So I'd say even now we have to mention these things. Only yesterday I had a talk with a certain person. He was very much surprised. He said, "It has never occurred to me that equality and freedom are quite different things." Yes, really different. And that is another point that a special attention should be paid to. These are not the same things. These are different things. That could be useful information for you when you will give your answers to pro-Western critics who demand equal rights for all religious organizations functioning in our country.
Для всех религиозных организаций, которые находятся в нашей стране. Нет, это будет уже принцип
демократии. That would not be a democracy. A democracy that is solved by a majority. That would be some other principle.
Какой принцип?
Which one?
Очевидно. Принцип
absolutely clear.
Плутократии.
A principle which in Greece will be a principle of plutocracy. But it's better not to translate the first word. But if we do translate it, it will mean richness. Plutos, richness. Kratos, power. Evidently. That is the very thing which they were driving at. It will be in all senses wrong if we give the same rights to both. That is another outstanding problem of our life. Huge congresses are convened to discuss the problem of freedoms, equality, and etc. Unfortunately, everything is so often so much intermingled that people are misled. They start speaking frankly. Well, we are to have the equal rights. Initially, each possesses equal rights to be elected, but after being elected, he gets special rights, which do not belong to anyone. And no one can possess these rights. If we want our society to be really stable, steadfast, and viable. So, what we're really speaking about, the rights which are granted to each religious organization have to be correlated by law with the degree of its recognition by the population. That is, by its democratic recognition, in which social truth is expressed and will be expressed. Do you see social truth? Where is it in actual implementation of the social principle, which is based on majority? In this case only, freedom and equality will not be in conflict with each other when they concern religious freedoms. Moreover, that would be the actual expression of God's love. Well, Mark Zelot said clearly, God, having given commandments on love, ordered to search God's truth, knowing that it is mother of love. Well, you see how the problem of justice and love are interconnected in social aspect. In social aspect, these problems are very rigidly linked up. It turns out that justifiable usage of the principle of democracy in part is a mother of love. Only on this principle it is possible to perform what we call love in its social expression. So, my friends, you see how the things look like. And one more remark. I'd like to remind to you Isaac Syrian wording.
Читаю. Ибо никогда человек не познает силы Божией в покое и свободе.
Come to know the power of God being at rest and in freedom. Do not be surprised when you approach virtue. Bitter, cruel sorrows will flood on you from everywhere. Thus, virtue is not respected, which is not accompanied by a difficulty of the deed. St. John the prophet said, virtue usually confronts difficulties. It deserves reproach when it is tied up with a state of rest. Do you see, freedom, how Kant expressed the idea, freedom is being advocated by everyone. It is directed to search for his peacefulness. What I want, I do. And it turned out a man is incapable